God sends bank account details. Mess it as well. Okay.
You know, blessing.
Sir.
You know, I warned you before about being defensive when I asked you a question, right?
Sir.
What? I said, you know, I warned you before about being defensive when I asked you a question.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So why are you still doing it?
I'm sorry, boss.
You are sorry.
Sorry.
That's not what the fuck I asked you, man. I asked you, why are you still doing it? It's a question.
Maybe I need to unconscious now.
Huh?
I'm sure I need to unconscious now.
Unconsciously how? What do you
mean? So I'm sure I need to unconscious because that has been a culture just at recent time.
A culture of what?
That has been my culture, but in recent time it's been excessively reflected.
Culture, as in, I don't understand. Is it your culture have?
Yeah, very defensive because most times I love to be objective about my
This is not your father's house. You don't have a say. Is that clear?
Yes,
but when you want to be defensive, you go and be defensive in your father's house or your boyfriend's parlor. Alright? As long as it's this office, you don't have a say. You don't need to be defensive. Is that clear? And I've been warning you, I'll be telling you, one day I'm going to show you my other side. Is that clear? So the earlier you get it straight, the better for you. Because if you see my other side, you are not going to like it. I'm your boss, all right? I'm a big support system to you. You are not doing me a favor, all right? There are many other young girls out there who will love your job, all right? And I cannot continue to be telling you, all you have to do is look at this phone, there's a laptop. When there's a comment, note it and document it. It's not a difficult job. I do what you're talking. Right? So I don't know what you're doing that you cannot commonly observe a small comment made there. Somebody out there watching is the one that's sending me messages while you are here. So it means that you're not doing your job. Do you need some time off? Do you want me to give you a month or two off? I can do that. I'm asking you a question. When I talk to you, fucking answer. You mad? Hey Chris, when I talk to you, stand up! What the hell is wrong with you, man? Hey Chris, man, what is wrong with you? Talking to you, are you mad? How many times do I have to correct you? Leave here, you are suspended for 1 month. Get the fuck out of here, man. Leave out, man, get out of here. Show you, how many times do I have to? Get out of here, man. 1 month, don't come back here, we don't want to see you. You're crazy, man. Talk to you, but that is still a do shushu. Call my manager for me. Call Josephine for me. You've been correcting somebody over and over again to do things right. Do this right. But this is your father's house. You're crazy, man. Don't want to see you here, man. Call Josephine for me, man. Do this thing for me. Collect the password of the laptop and the phones. Drop the phone. Blessing suspended for 1 month. You guys be responsible for the God's in kitchen tomorrow. Alright? I'm trying to appreciate. Alright? So that's what we're gonna do. My manager, where did that woman really cook?
I'll call her.
Okay, you have a number?
Yes.
Okay, call her. I'm gonna give you some money right now. I'll give you some money and you guys make the kitchen happen. Okay? Call Ruth for me. Can you be talking to someone, advising someone? I think because we are giving our staff so many privileges, they are taking advantage of it. Collect all the passwords from Blessing. This is your new office. You document every single thing we are doing here. Is that clear? What did I say?
You said I will document everything we're doing here. Collect the password.
Collect the password to the phones, the laptop, all the information we have. Collect it from Blessing, including your office phone. Alright? Call her for me. She can go home and sleep with her dad, She can go out there and be speaking English. And you'll be correcting one person for 3, 4, 5 times. You can have this. Alright. You know, the problem with Nigerian workforce is that a lot of persons are very, very lazy and they take the job. They are telling me, oh, it's been my culture. Oh, it's not your father's house. right? Who owns this? Take it away from me, man. Where's my other black phone? The iPhone I gave to you. Alright. Alright, so Godsend Foundation family, if you have been following us, you realize that I'm a very, very patient guy. I think that I'm a very, very fair guy when it comes to handling my stuff. I mean, come on, man. How can somebody that is watching video from afar not be the one screenshotting and documenting things that you are supposed to be doing? I'm the one doing all the talking. I'm doing all the talking and still looking at comments, looking at you are just there doing nothing and speaking English. When I ask you what's up, you still have to say, oh, boss, I'm sorry, I didn't see you. You say, you still been making excuses. All right, so I think she deserves to stay home for 1 month. Then after 1 month, we may decide if she want to come back. If she don't want to come back, we are going to replace her right away. Hello? 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 Okay, so I think it's time for us to go now. All these women are still out there. Many of them, they will not let me leave until I give them something. Ah, wow. Problem, food everywhere. Tell my manager to give me the list of what we're going to cook tomorrow. Hello? Yeah, I greet you. Yeah, you too much, oh. Yeah. It's not a problem. We don't make decisions until we have given so many chances. There's no forgiveness. Even if Jesus Christ come down to tell me that, I won't do it. Let her take 1 month off so that she can stay at home and you know, so that she understands what we try to do for her. We are the one helping her, she's not helping us. And the little job that you have to just do comments, you can't even look at it. I'm telling you, shui. Man, I'm not here for fun, man. Oh, my wife is in Canada. You think I don't miss my wife? Or you think I don't miss my family? Get the job done, man. All right, much love. You know, of course I'm meeting my wife. Of course I'd love to be with my wife. But, you know, I'm doing this job. You are getting paid. You know, I'm encouraging all you guys. I mean, all you need to do is, you know, be loyal to your boss. You know? All right, any other questions? What's up?
I'm going to spoil my phone. Could you call me? I still can't call me.
Why you give us something on your phone? Call something on your phone. You stay here.
Come on, phone.
Why you give us something on your phone?
The phone gets more phone before. So I know coffee user now, coffee part.
On top of table there.
Just now, this morning. That's you give us something on your phone. I don't know. Yeah. Someone there, you go carry it in. You call my SIM card. Call my memory card. Doctor, face inside that one. Call the phone now. Why you do that one now? Touch the phone, tell me to tell me what to do.
What happened to his phone, man? Say yes. What happened to his phone? Speak up, man.
Before you gave me this money, you said I should give. And I said, what to put is so bad. And I said that I will not give him. When I left, I had to go and carry the SIM card. And I put it plus the memory card. And I check my dad for work. Then I came and I said that the phone is not good. I will have to move the SIM card. But I said everything, the phone is flushed now.
Okay. He wanted you to have the phone. He wanted you to give him the phone.
Yeah.
It's okay. I know I always told you that things that don't belong to you, you should not touch them. Eh? But the phone, not be your main phone, Abby.
Sir?
No, that's not your main phone, Abby.
No. The phone will work again. But I don't know if it's a receive call. But if you don't know, this way the...
Okay. But you are not supposed to leave your phone in there. Our office is not a storage place now. Your phone supposed to be in your pocket, not be for there. Hello, Dion Osagie. Call Ruth for me. Hello, Dion Osagie. Yeah, good afternoon. How are you? Yeah, what? Huh? Yeah, we are here. Number 24, Exotic Street. Exotic, Airport Road and Exotic. Airport Road, behind the palace. Any problem? Okay, no worries. I greet you. Yeah. Yeah, no worries. No worries. Yeah. Yeah. All right. So this is what you do for me now. You're going to get the password, right? Let me see that phone. That's my phone too now.
Yeah, that's there. I kept it. Everything
okay, kept it there.
Yes, sir.
All right, so this is what you do. This is a God-sent foundation phone number. All right? When the call comes in, all you have to say, this is God-sent foundation. How can I help you? Right? Then if there's any information, are you listening to me?
Yes, sir. I'm listening.
You sure?
Yes.
Why are you going to fall? Is my voice pushing you to fall?
Yes, sir.
All right? This is Dion Osagie, this is God Sent Foundation. How can I help you? Make sure you have, I'll give you this. Very, very important, eh? Take this, get a pen, make sure you document all information, okay? Then the other phone, the one we use to God Sent Inquiry, just get all the password you need to get, Facebook, everything, get it from Blessing, okay? You'll be sitting here and doing the job, all right? Any other question? Okay, not for now. Tomorrow kitchen, you guys make it happen. Tell my manager to give me a list of what you guys are going to cook tomorrow. Alright?
She's
writing it already. Okay, Lucky, you understand that your job is very needed here. More than 5 times, you don't leave for work. I should not be here before you. Are you listening to me? I'm not supposed to come work before you. I like you so much, but let it stop, bro. Alright? Next time I come here before you, you are going to lose your job.
God bless you.
What happened?
He said, I always told her to give me money to buy bread for to pay with it down. You told me I should pay with it before 11 o'clock. Yep. And what you told me, so bless you, so make her wait. So I will now wait till she come. The time she just come, she still like, no. Because they go for rude. So before I went to go and buy bread,
okay, okay, no problem. I like your job, okay? You are a great guy and I don't have any issue with you. Alright? At least before I come work, everything needs to be arranged, right?
Yes.
Before it needs to be on, the light needs to be on, the internet, everything needs to be set up. Alright? I came here today at 9 o'clock. All you guys were still running around. It's not fair. Alright? I love you guys so much. You guys need to work together so I can effect all these changes, okay? Alright? Alright? I'm going to train you, okay? Don't be shy. You are a very shy person, but don't be shy. You can get the job done, okay? Alright, it's very, very easy. It won't be a problem. Are you enjoying working with us so far?
Yes.
Your dad is a pastor. Is your dad praying for us?
Yes, praying for you.
Yeah?
Yes, praying for
you. Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I always see his message. That is a bishop of God. Okay? Alright, try this thing for me.
Okay.
Alright. Of course, I'm not. You don't worry. Just make sure everything is taken care of. Then, you have an ATM card, right?
Yes, sir.
Alright, so you and Mama Angel, you guys do the estimate for tomorrow. Then I will send money to your account for the Gustin Kitchen. Our brother Sonny and Two Balance is having the birthday party, okay?
Alright, thank you.
Alright. Call my manager for me.